Hello dear students, today we will see human respiration. This process is a biochemical process. Biochemical, chemical means it is a chemical reaction, and bio word is used because it is taking place in the cells of living organisms. That is why it is called biochemical process. A chemical process which is taking place in the living cells is called biochemical process. Respiration involves two steps mainly, breathing and cellular oxidation. Breathing is a physical process. It only involves exchange of gases between the lungs and the atmosphere. These two processes are inhalation of oxygen. That means when we inhale, we take in oxygen that goes into our lungs, and exhalation of CO2. That means when we release carbon dioxide from our lungs outside in the atmosphere. And cellular oxidation, this process takes place in the cells of the body. That is why it is called cellular oxidation, and it is a biochemical process. Actual chemical biochemical process takes place during cellular oxidation in the cells. What happens during cellular oxidation? There is breakdown of glucose into carbon dioxide, water, and energy is released. This energy which is released is stored in the form of adenosine triphosphate or ATP molecules. ATP molecules are called energy currency of the cells. So how will you define respiration? Respiration is a biochemical process which involves inhalation of O2, exhalation of CO2, breakdown of glucose into carbon dioxide, water, and large amount of energy is released. Now, what is the purpose? What is the need to have respiration in the body of living organisms? It is providing energy, and this energy is utilized for carrying out all life processes of the organisms. Life processes means nutrition, all internal working of the organs, and to carry out physical activities, movement, work, etc. In respiratory system, in the other video you have seen that system consists of many parts, and functions of each parts were explained in that video. Today we will see what is the mechanism of breathing. How is breathing carried out? Mechanism of breathing. So first we will see how is inhalation carried out. Whether it is inhalation or exhalation, it is a combined action of three structures. Those three structures are ribs and the muscles present between ribs. That they are called internal intercostal muscles and external intercostal muscles, and diaphragm. These are the three structures which have their combined action towards inhalation and exhalation. Now we know that human body is divided into two cavities with the help of a muscular sheet, and this muscular sheet is called diaphragm. This upper to the diaphragm cavity is called thoracic cavity, and the lower one is called abdominal cavity. Thoracic cavity, this cavity, the upper cavity consists of rib cage. Rib cage consists of 12 pairs of ribs, and it is a cage which is protecting two very important organs of your body, and those organs are heart and lungs. And this rib cage and ribs with diaphragm have very important role in the process of inhalation. So we will see here, suppose these lines are representing your rib cage of the thoracic cavity, and these lines are showing ribs. So first action during the inhalation process will be ribs move outward from both the sides, and then they move left upward from both the sides. So there will be ribs move outward and upward. That means the size of or volume of the cavity will increase. This will be first action. This movement takes place with the help of muscles which are present in between the ribs. Where, what is the diaphragm? Diaphragm is located at the base of rib cage. This diaphragm remains in dome shape. Dome shaped like this. Right? And when it contracts, it will flatten. That means, second action will be movement of diaphragm downwards. So, second point, diaphragm flattens. Now, see, first action, they are moving outward. Second action, diaphragm going downward. So, volume of the thoracic cavity will increase. This will increase the pulmonary pressure also. Pulmonary pressure is pressure of air inside the lungs. So, volume increases, pressure of the lungs decreases. If you compare it with atmospheric pressure outside, that pressure is higher. Comparison of this pressure with outer atmospheric pressure. So, air always rushes from high pressure to low pressure. So, that means high pressure to low pressure, outside to inside, taking in oxygen and causing inhalation. Right? Now, during exhalation, the process will, all the processes will be reverse. Fine. So, in that case, volume of the cavity will decrease. Now, we'll draw again, but this time we need to draw a smaller thoracic cavity. Why it is smaller? Why volume is decreasing? Because now ribs move downwards and inwards. They move downward and inward. Diaphragm, which was flat in first condition during inhalation, it becomes dome shaped again. Diaphragm is now dome shaped because it has moved upward. So, both these actions will result in the volume of the thoracic cavity to decrease and pressure will now increase. So, this pressure is also called pulmonary pressure, means per pressure inside the lungs. Now, compare with atmospheric pressure, it is lower. This lower atmospheric pressure will now cause movement of air from high pressure to low pressure, that is removal of CO2 which is present in the lungs, causing exhalation. So, movement of air inside and outside the lungs, it is all controlled by the movement of ribs and diaphragm, and it is with the help of pressure, high and low pressure inside the lungs and outside the lungs in the atmosphere. Learn this properly, and these are two comparative processes. Thank you.